What is going on, guys? It's Ben here. In today's video, we're going to give you guys some awesome tips about the new draft challenge for the new cards. Now, you don't necessarily have to win this challenge to unlock the cards. Honestly, you can open them up randomly in a chest and get unlock them right there. But the challenge is good because you get a chest, you get some cards, you get some gold. So we already got the ice, the giant snowball unlocked. Today we're gonna be trying to get the 12 wins here. You can see we are 10-1. Keep in mind, guys, if you are new to the channel, subscribe because we are gonna be maxing out the Royal Hogs and the giant snowball over the next few days. So you got some awesome decks with them as well and everything else. And then maybe later today I'll do a double upload today, open up some emotes as well. So without further ado, the tips here, I gotta say, this is one of the most interesting draft challenges in a very long time because a lot of cards that usually people would like never want are actually really good. Like the Bomb Tower is good. I would say Valkyrie and Fireball are like must-haves. If you get them in your rotation, you want to take them. I've been even giving away the Golem in some drafts so I could take like a, I don't know. It's so crazy. Like the Wizard's good. You want to have splash damage or area damage. If you don't have those cards, you're going to be in a very tough situation. So, because the Royal Hogs, you know someone's going to have them. Either you're going to have them or your opponent's going to have them. So either you take all of the area damage cards, so if your opponent happens to give you the Royal Hogs, you have a good shot at winning. Or if you give the opponent the Royal Hogs, make sure you have a counter for them, like either a Wizard, I don't know, like, I will say this, a lot of times they give you the option for either a lightning or a rocket and a fireball or a poison. Like those are like you can either take the lightning or the fireball. Take the fireball. You can take the rocket or the poison. Take the poison. It helps so much. I would say the giant snowball is actually pretty good as well. A lot of times it's like giant snowball or bats. Usually I'll just give them the bats because the giant snowball takes care of that anyways. I don't know, man. It's a toss-up a lot of times what you want to take. And don't be afraid to give away the Golem if you already have some win conditions. Like, you can counter. Like, Rascals are in here. If you get the Rascals and your opponent can't counter the Rascals, like, they don't have a log, they don't have arrows, or they don't have, like, a fireball or poison, they are in a very tough spot because the Rascals are such a dominant card. So without further ado, wish me luck. I will hope you guys did well on the channel. Let me know how you got, or not on the channel, the challenge. Hopefully you did well. Let me know how you guys fared, and then what do you think of the new cards and the update and everything. I, for one, am in love with all the changes. Yes, it's a little bit smaller side. I know I talked about this in the sneak peeks, a little bit on the smaller side, but a lot of quality of life stuff, more gold, chest got buffed and everything else. So, and also in wars, you can actually look at your opponents that you're facing. That's really, really nice too. Our war, though, we're working. We're trying to get that second place. We'll see what happens. Still a lot of war to go. I think first place is a little bit out of reach, depending on if they get 13 attacks. But without further ado, wish me luck. Let's get into this. Dark Prince is also super solid in this. You want to take him. Normally, I would say take the Lava Hound, but for this draft, I'm going to take the Rascals. And I'm going to take the Poison. So they don't have a counter for my Rascals. Fire Spirits are also very solid. I'm gonna take the Fire Spirits because they are good versus the Royal Hogs as well. Whereas the Giant Snowball, it's okay, but the Fire Spirits are actually better. So I might need them. But I actually have the Royal Hogs myself and a Witch. Okay. Depending on what he has for area damage, I don't want to drop the Royal Hogs too early. Don't be afraid to split push them either, guys. Like, if you notice they have, like, a Valkyrie or something that's a little crazy and tough for you to deal with, do not be afraid to split push your Royal Hogs. Since I see the Inferno Dragon there, that's a tough card for me to deal with. So I'm going to drop the Royal Hogs because the Inferno Dragon takes a little bit to ramp up. And I don't know why it's lagging. If you notice, I don't know if it's on just my iPad or what, but we're off to a good start here. Have my Rascals. He gave me the log, so he does not have the log for the Rascals. I didn't even notice that until just now, until I dropped them. Oh, well, that's really, really good, because like I said, guys, the Rascals are just such a dominant card. It's literally crazy how they can chew through so many things. Like, a lot of times, it's Rascal or Giant. I'll take the Rascals in almost every scenario, as long as, like, unless I accidentally gave them some card that counters the Rascals so well or something like that. I don't know. They're just such a... Or unless... I'll give them the Rascals if I have the counter. Like, if I have a log, okay, I'll give you the Rascals. It's the Rascal Girls that are really nasty. I'm just gonna throw on the Fire Spirits here. He has a good Lava Hound, like, battle deck, to be completely honest. And he has the Lightning, so he's probably gonna Lightning my Witch. And I'm actually just gonna go in with my Royal Hogs here then. Because he has to be a little bit low on Elixir. We'll have our log ready just in case if he has anything else. No, he does not. So, good start to this one. For sure. The lightning, he's probably gonna use that every time on my witch, but I'm gonna save the rascals for basically the lava hound, because that's the main card that I'm really scared of, and I have some decent counters for it. So, and thank God I took the poison. If I gave him the poison, these rascals would be useless. He would just poison right now when his lava hound's bearing down the tower, and I wouldn't have many air counters. He does have a fireball though, so that's actually pretty solid. But I'm gonna go in. I'm gonna say I gotta go in and try and go for the three crowns. So that's what we're gonna try and do here. I'm eating a lot of damage from his lava hound, but we're okay at the moment. I'm bleeding out elixir. I don't know why I didn't use the fireball to counter earlier in the match. I probably should have played better defense, because you can see how me letting go of that lava hound, I saw green. I didn't register in my mind, like, yo, that's a fireball right there. Okay, so we have our witch down, 10 seconds left anyways. So we were so aggressive, it didn't give him enough time to make a push, because otherwise he would have lost anyways. So he had to defend us. Does not really matter. I don't know, like, maybe we got lucky and he didn't have the fireball in his opening hand when we did that hog rider push. But hey, we'll take it. Good game. Good luck, sir. So, 11-1 here. Let's see if we can get the victory. Now, I don't really particularly like the minion horde, because like I said, you're usually taking a lot of area damage stuff. There's a lot of area damage stuff in this challenge. So the minion horde's kind of lackluster a lot of the times. No doubt I am taking that. I'm gonna take the fire spirits, because that's actually a really bad counter for the minion horde. I'm actually gonna give them the Royal Hogs. I feel confident enough with my Rascals and my Dark Prince to take care of them in a nice fashion. And he gave me the Goblin Barrel. So he might have it like the log or something, but I can have some sort of bait whether he wants to take care of the Rascals or that Goblin Barrel. So we're in an okay spot. Plus, I'm gonna assume he might have a Fireball too. Fireball or Poison probably with this, because he gave us this Rocket. So I don't know. It really depends on how this is gonna play out. So I have the Lava Hound. So I have some nice air counters. And I have, like, I'm just gonna drop these just to kind of see what he has. I probably should have dropped them on the other lane, because he already has some damage over there. That was a little bit misplay by my part. So, Lava Hound going in. He gave me it, so he has to have something. Or it must have been such a good, so he does have arrows, okay. So he has arrows. Caught me off at a weird time, kind of, because I don't really have elixir and neither does he, so we're kind of just trading blows here. I think he's gonna get the better end of it right here. So he actually got the better end of that little trade there. The Royal Hogs just came out so quick, so fast. But we do have a Dark Goblin, so he has arrows. I'm not gonna show my minion horde until I see those arrows get dropped. Kind of unfortunate, but I do have some nice arrow bait. Like, I can bait the arrows or at least be fine of something, but I don't want to give him that much of a elixir advantage off of that. So we'll just have to sit back and wait and see what he decides to do. Now, since I need to get this tower, and my Royal Hog counters are not that great. So if I save my fire spirits this time around, I'll be in a better situation. So I wish I had elixir. I'm gonna save this minion horde again. Actually, no. You know what? I know he has that. I'm gonna go in with it. I know he has the snowball. I don't know. I don't really like how that played out. I probably should have saved that minion horde, because now he knows I had it and he's gonna be extra careful with that. He's only gonna use the arrows if he needs them. Well, I guess not. He's gonna go for the tower. We're just gonna be really aggressive here, because I kind of have to be. So I have 30 seconds, so I have to be a little bit up forward with my Lava Hound to get to the tower in time. Now he does have the giant too, okay, so he's gonna have to arrow one of these things. Left. I do have a rocket, but I don't know if I can get to it in time. It wouldn't have mattered anyways. 432, and I didn't even get there enough damage in time. So, Quaker did end up getting the match. He got his 12 wins there. I really did like our draft, honestly. I think maybe I was just a little bit too aggressive on the pushes. I don't really know. This one's tricky. The Royal Giant's really solid. But I like the Royal Hogs better for my playstyle and how I like to play. I'm gonna take the bats here. I'm gonna need something for that Royal Giant. Usually I give them the Giant Snowball, but we're mixing it up a little bit. So we have a Hunter, that's really solid. That's gonna be really good versus the Royal Giant. Nice. Plus we have a Goblin Hut, that's gonna be solid too. Okay, so I'm okay with my cards that I have right now. I don't think I have a big tank. We know he has the Giant Snowball. Oh, and a Mega Knight. So his Battle Axe is actually quite heavy. I'm going to try and use this push to my advantage at the moment, where the Mega Knight is off to the side. But now it's going to go for the Royal Hogs, ain't it? No! So we just totally got countered. We do have a Giant Skeleton, though. That's really key. So my Royal Hogs are pretty much going to be useless, because he's just going to mainly save that Mega Knight unless I can get it out with my Giant Skeleton. I mean, we have the drop on him with the tower damage. I just have to be so conservative with that Royal Giant. See what he wants to do about my Hunter. Well, we got the Tesla over there. So that gives us a path to get to the tower. I'm glad that I do have the Giant Skeleton. I'm gonna have to push very carefully with that. And my Lumberjack. So I'm gonna have to catch him like over committing to a push on one side and then just trying to dominate him on the other side. That's what it's gonna have to do. Or split push my Hogs. I don't ideally want to do that. He does have the Giant Snowball still. So I'm actually gonna just poison this. I need to get it out of my hand. It's not a very good card right now. I'll throw my Giant Skeleton just in case he wants to like drop something. Okay. We got the Mega Knight out. That Tesla just hurts so bad, man. How do I want to go about this, dude? Am I just going to have to poison him down? Because I have the counters for the Royal Giant. I'm just not going to drop. I'm not going to drop my Royal Hogs unless I feel like the opportunity is so wide open. Like right here, I guess. All right, so that put us a little bit ahead. Royal G in the back. He's gonna try and do a huge push over here. I'm okay with that. Mega Knight on this side though. Wow. Like, I can afford to eat a little bit of damage from that Mega Knight if it actually ends up getting to my towers, so that's not the end of the world. I'm just gonna cycle a poison. I mean, I have his Mega Knight on lockdown. I'm okay on time. Cycle the arrows too, because I need to get the new card.
I wish I had my poison in hand. Put on the lumberjack, I guess. That was probably a little bit of an overdrop. I think I panicked a little bit. But I'm okay because this Royal Giant will not get tower damage on me just yet. So, one more arrow and one more poison and we will be good to go. We'll finally get our 12 wins. Well, man, that was a tough one. Like, you see, you just... If you have the counters to them, a lot of people would... No, I'm guilty of this too sometimes. A lot of people would press a little bit and be too aggressive. But look, like, those Royal Hogs were not doing anything. There was no sense in me dropping them. And if you have the counters, just play it safe, sit back, to cycle your spells if you can, and just see what happens. It's better to not overextend and either have the chance at winning later on in the match or just going to a draw. A draw is okay as well. It doesn't count a loss in the challenge. So I was fine with that going to a draw, so I get another chance. Or you can see right there, winning as well by basically just countering all his stuff, not being too aggressive, just playing passive. And my gosh, man, show me them 12 wins. Now we can finally start maxing them out. I mean, I could have did it before, but I want to get 12 wins first because that's usually how the progression goes. You get 12 wins with the challenge, you unlock the cards, and then you go. But finally, collected here. Good start. Got the 12 wins. Hopefully my tips helped you guys out. If you have any tips for anyone else or just in general, let us know how you did in the challenge. I'm sure people would love to see the feedback because I know a lot of you are probably saving your free entry until you see how, like, the best opportunity, the best ways to win the challenge pretty much. And we do get a legendary. Noticed as well, the gold has been increased. So now I'm not just wasting when I open up chests to actually acquire some gold again. I am fully maxed here though. We did get Royal Hogs and the Giant Snowball in our 12 win chest. So that's really cool. That's going to be very helpful moving forward. So we'll be maxing them out soon. Show you guys the Battle Axe and everything else. I'm glad we clutched up. Hope you guys enjoyed the video though. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Stay tuned for more. I'm probably going to have another upload later tonight. I might be just getting the emotes and then doing my clan battles and then probably upgrading the new cards a little bit as well. So a lot of things going on. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you're new to the channel and I'll see you guys later.